Okay. I'm in Newcastle University's Maths Penthouse with my good friend David Cushing. We've worked out a little card trick based on a trick by Percy Diaconis and Ron Graham that was written up by our very own column about 4 years ago for the MAA. We've reverse engineered it, I think. So, David, can you show us the trick?
So first of all, Christian, could you pick up some of the cards, just a portion, and put them down there? And now I want you to look at the top six cards and tell me each of their colours respectively.
Okay. Red. Black. Red. Black. Red. And red.
Right, so the principle of this trick, it's a mathematical based trick, as you probably gathered being on this website. But so giving the colours of each of those cards, there exists a method to calculate what each of those cards are. So the last card in the sequence is, given the colours, we can tell that is a diamond, and it is the six of diamonds.
Yep, very good.
Six of diamonds. And technically you should be able to do this in your head, but at the minute I'm just using pen and paper.
Okay.
So the next card is the three of hearts.
Yep.
The two of clubs.
Very good.
The nine of hearts.
Yep.
The king of clubs.
Yep.
And finally, we have the seven of diamonds.
Very good.
So with a bit of practice, you should be able to do that in your head. I'm still using paper, but it's instantly becoming much quicker to do.
Okay.
So how this trick uses it, how the trick works, it uses something called the de Bruijn sequence. And what a de Bruijn sequence is I'll draw a quick one here, a very, very simple one, is a sequence of, we're just using binary de Bruijn sequences in this trick, but you can use any size alphabet. So our alphabet is just size 2. And what's special about the sequence is if you take any, this one's going to be two size words. If you take any length 2 word here, 00, the next one, 01, the next one loops back. No, sorry, 11. The next one loops back, 10. These are all unique.
Okay. And that's all the two digit.
Yes, and that is all
strings.
The two digits.
Okay.
Ones. So the idea of the trick is if we can have a deck of 52 cards, such that each set of six strings, so here they're working out with the trick I just did. I was using ones for blacks and zeros for reds. If I can have the deck of 52 cards such that each order of six colour patterns is unique, then I should therefore be able to tell what the six cards are.
Okay.
So what you'll notice here is this was a power of 2 because it spans them all. So what we did was, there's a paper on this subject by Percy Diaconis and Ron Graham that has a de Bruijn sequence of length 64. So what we did was we took it, and it has a very nice way of generating. Is that it? Also, with this evil.
5 zeros.
Now, what this sequence does is you add these two digits up to get the... so you add I and I plus 1 to get I plus 6. 0, 0, 0. 0, 0, 0. 0 is 0, 0. 0, 0, 0. 0, 1 is 1. 1 is 0 is 1. 0, 0, 0. 0, 0, 0. 0, 0, 0. 0 is 1 is 1. 1 is 1 is 0 because we're working in base 2. 1 at 0 is 1, and this goes on until you've generated 64 different strings, and it turns out this encodes every single 6 string. So we then, well, Christian did something with a computer that took away 12 of these elements, and we had these six strings. We then had the problem of how to encode it. So we again used, I've seen it in a few locations, but I believe basically this method was in the paper of Dichonus and Graham as well. So if you take any six string, I'll take for example the last one I read out, for 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1. I need this to represent the card for each one. So these back two digits here represent the suit. 1, 1 represents spades. So I had a little chart here. 0, 0 is diamonds, 0, 1 is clubs, 1, 0 is hearts, and 1, 1 is spades. The first four represent the number. And what I do is I convert it into its binary number. In this case, 0001 is 1. I then add 1 to it to get 2. So I got the 2 of spades. Now, the reason I'm adding 1 to is because I start with 0000, which I want to be the ace. So I need to add 1. Now, you may remember in the trick, I got to this point. 0, 0, 1, and I said I couldn't name the card. And the problem with this is that if I add these up in binary, we get 2, add 4, add 8, is 14, add 1 is 15, which isn't the card. So there are 6 different versions of this in our sequence, and it turns out you can't make the sequence not to include any of these bad ones that don't work. So the solution to this is to remember the six different errors and just replace them in with another card. And just back to how I worked the trick, you'll notice this nice rule that generates the sequence in the paper I was talking about. I can use it to generate the cards. So this sequence tells me what the last card is. So if I want to know what the next card is, I need to know what this sequence is, this digit is. And to get it, I simply add the first and last up. So 1 add 1 is 0. I then look at this card to get it. So I'll what I was doing for easiness is I cross that off and just analyse this. So 0, 0 is diamonds. 1, 1, 1 in binary is 7. Add 1 is 8. So that would be the 8 of diamonds. Okay. So I'm going to show you a quick example using the actual cards. So first of all, if I cut anywhere and then deal the first 6 cards, we now want to decode this. And what hopefully this should give us is the 4 of hearts. So I've got my little cheat sheet here, so we can already see this is 1, 0, which is a heart, which is good. So now we look at the binary digits of this, which is 0, 0, 1, 1, which is 3, add 1 is 4, the 4 of hearts. Now what we would want to know now is what the previous, to calculate what this is, we need to know what the previous card would have been. Now red plus red is red, so it would have been this red card here, and I'll just get rid of there for a second. So now hopefully this will tell us this is the 2 of spades. So the last 2 cards is black, black, 1, 1 of spades. And 0, 0, 0, 1 is 1, add 1, 2, 2 spades. And again, to know what this card is, we would do black plus red is 1 plus 0 is 1, so it is a black card, which we can see here, obviously. And we're probably going to get to an error at some point, but we'll keep going. So black, black, spades, 1, 0, 0, 0, and binary is 8,
mm-hmm.
Coincidental, add 1 is 9, and we could go on and on. So 1 add 1 is 0, is red, and onwards. Now, so far this looks difficult to do in your head, but it should be okay with practice. A book here, unfortunately the library's removed a nice fancy dust cover. So, Magical Mathematics by the same people I mentioned before. So, in this book, they have lots of math-based magic tricks, and they have an entire section devoted to the Brown sequences. Universal Cycles, that's what it's called. Oh, this is awesome. The Gilbert pencil that I love, and the Mandelbrot set, that's good.
How did they work the Mandelbrot set into it?
I don't know, but it's going to be amazing, isn't it? And have you mixed these up?
Maybe.
If you have, that's it.
Oh, good point. Let's see.